In lane 3, Great Britain. In lane 4, Serbia. In lane 5, Canada. In lane 6, Bulgaria. In lane 7, Italy. In lane 8, Cuba.
Just about ready then for the opening race in this canoe sprint week here at Eton Dorney. Adam Evander Coverdon,
1 minute to the start.
From Canada,
1 minute
30-year-old
to
from
the
Toronto,
start.
World champion in this event. Miroslav Kirchev alongside him, fifth in the K1 500 European Championship this year. From Italy, Maximilian Benazzi. First Olympics for this man. Good record in the 5,000 metres. Not an event run in the Olympic Games, but
paddlers to the start line, please. Paddlers to the start line.
And Jorge Antonio Garcia went out in the semi-finals in 1,000 metres in Beijing. So it's the first five to go through here, plus one fastest loser, Tim Brabants. Defending champion goes in lane 3, but injuries in the build-up 2011 really wrecked for him, and gradually coming back, but a very tall order to repeat his feats of Beijing. Away they go, a surge of spray as they take themselves out. Tim Brabants will hear the support of the crowd very soon as they race from just 1,000 metres, of course. No silence deep in the course as the rowers had from 2,000 metres, but as expected, Adam van Coverdon is there. Also going out very quickly, Josh Otanga of the Cook Islands.
Van Coverdon, as we said, got out to a great start. He often likes to lead the race. You see it there, he wants to get a great pickup.
And Tang is actually easing off. He's pulling up after his explosive start, so it's left to Van Coverdon to set the pace. World champion last year in Hungary, also former 500 metres world champ.
Brabants looked like he was also coming up to the field there, but you see the drive as Adam van Coverdon gets his boat running smoothly. We're looking at the bow of the boat. We want to see it looking smooth and not jumping about too much. Now Tim Brabants is coming in to shot, but Adam van Coverdon is really taking the lead in this race, as we would expect to see.
So again, first five through to the semi-finals. And at the moment, it is comfortably Adam van Coverdon setting the pace as they hit the halfway mark.
And they're into a good rhythm. We really see the athlete's stroke rates around 100 strokes per minute. But with this first heat, with 1-5 going through to the semi-final, we will probably see the pace not get to quite the heights that we would expect to see later in the competition, as it is hopefully for Adam van Coverdon quite a formality, as he's got a massive lead out here on the water this morning.
What he's doing at the moment, Van Coverden, is making a statement about his credentials, about his form, and the noise starts to lift now from the Eton Dorney support. This Canadian dominating, but much of the cheers for the defending Olympic champion Tim Brabants, who is fighting away there. He will qualify as they go through the three-quarter mark. Van Coverden comfortably in front, Brabants now up into second, with Jorge Antonio Garcia of Cuba coming through in third. And then Van Coverden looking so at ease with his stroke, with his rhythm, and just a little look around.
He's keeping his shoulders relaxed as he drives the paddles into the water at the front, connects through his middle of his body, and then drives through the legs. It's all about the connection between your arms, the drive in the legs, and the rotation in the body is how you get the long reach and the strong, powerful strokes.
So Van Coverden is comfortable. Marko Tomicevic coming through well on Brabants, who's fading just a little bit, but it is the first five to go through, so these five will be there. And now perhaps a little bit about conserving energy, but Van Coverden through easily. And those five are your five through. Brabants in there, Miroslav Kurchev, Jorge Antonio Garcia as well, Marko Tomicevic. And that race was utterly dominated by Adam Van Coverden. And he and the four behind him will move through into the semi-finals later on today. Difficult to know what to make of Tim Brabants, which a lot of the home support will be focusing on there, whether he had a bit more to offer.
I would think it would be, once he knew he was in a top five position to qualify through to the semi-finals, which is only in about an hour and a half's time, they'd be looking to conserve as much energy as possible. But Adam Van Coverden really did make a statement.
Well, Josh Utanga getting a roar as well as he comes over, suffering a bit, an injury, tries to do a wheelie over the line. But Adam Van Coverden, again, he'll face very strong competition from the likes of Max Hoff, the German. Murray Stewart as well from Australia, Eric Veras Larsen, Rennie Poulsen. But here, he got off to a good start, Van Coverden, and surged out, never troubled thereafter.
Now, after his disappointment in Beijing, where he actually blew out in the 1,000 metres, led it out hard, and then just blew up in the latter stage of the race, he's going to certainly want to make sure he doesn't make any mistakes again here in London.
The technique and the strength of the core and the upper body as he brought himself to the finish line. This 30-year-old from Toronto safely through. Adam Van Coverden, Tim Brabants also in there in the top five through to the semi-finals. Confirmation of the results, and Brabants easing down a little bit at the end, but Tomicevic, Kirchev and Garcia as well, and the defending champion Tim Brabants through to the semi-finals. So Adam Van Coverden, certainly the man of the first heat, straight to the second heat. Francisco Cubelos Sanchez, Spain, just 19 years old. Not a big man, just 5'7". Bronze in the European Championships in June, though. The World Junior Champion in 2009. There is Ale Urania from Belarus.
To the start.
First Olympics, but third in the World Championships in this event in Poznan 2 years ago. Anders Gustafsson, fourth Olympic Games took a silver behind Adam Vancouver at last year's World Championships. Ben Fui, also one of the more seasoned competitors, 33 in his third Olympics. Amadreza Telebian from Iran, gold in the Asian Games in Guangzhou 2 years ago. And Mustafa Mansour, 23-year-old Egyptian, will also be going in the K1 200, the sprints later in the week. Into the start buckets they go, and they will drop.
Line 8 forward into the start line, to
Mustafa Mansour. Forward he goes into the bucket, back out again, not happy.
Hold your position in the start, please. Thank you. Ready, set.
Not comfortable, Mustafa Mansour. The buckets drop and away they go. And Ben Fui from New Zealand getting off to a powerful start.
See the pickup as they really drive through this first part, get their boats up and running, and then they'll look to drop their level, drop their pacing a little bit so that they can get into the rhythm of the race.
Xu Yubu of China, 24-year-old from Shandong in the east of the country, he's off to a flyer. Also competing in the sprint here, though he has that initial surge.
We do see over this longer 1,000-metre racing that you have real different race plans. So some of the athletes will plan to go out fast and really get a good lead and then try and hold on, and others will actually hold back.
And Zhou Yubo has been pegged back now by Gustafsson, who crosses the 250 mark first. Cabello Sanchez in third, and then Ali Urenia.
Gustafsson is a training partner of Adam Vancouverden, so it looks like they have quite similar plans. Take it out hard and try and lead this race.
Looks like training has been going well. 33-year-old Gustafsson. He took silver behind Vancouverden at the World Championships last year.
Looking comfortable at the moment as he drives the blades into the water, gets a nice catch at the front of the boat. We want to see the paddles really driving deep down into the water, the shoulders relaxed, the heads nice and straight down. And it's when they get tired, the fatigue starts hitting in that last part of this race. They have to start focusing, make sure they don't tighten up.
Through the halfway mark, and Gustafsson just shy of the pace set by Vancouverden in the first heat. A good view from the overhead camera of the technique.
Great rotation and the drive through the knees. Rotation is what gives the paddlers the length and the reach on their paddles. It takes incredible amounts of core strength to be able to control that in these really skinny, narrow boats.
There's no one set build that's good for it either. Zhu Yubo is 6'4", was a promising basketball player. Then you look at much shorter Francisco Cabello Sanchez. Again, similar to the first heat, Gustafsson dominating as Vancouverden, his training partner, did. And then a battle between the rest for the other places. Five to go through, plus the fastest loser. So again, five at the moment, almost separating themselves. But in fact, Amadreza Telebian of Iran is coming through to get himself in the mix as well.
Zealand in second at the moment. It's been over in the UK, actually training with Greg Britton's Tim Brabant, looking strong.
In clear water between Gustafsson and the rest, but very good race developing if Telebian of Iran can get himself up there for that final spot. Five to go through, thinking about the clock as well, because it matters with the fastest loser to go through. Just one fastest loser from three heats.
The rotation, the drive, this is when the arms start to burn, the lungs are at full capacity.
So Gustafsson takes it, and those five at the front again. In the end, Amadreza Telebian couldn't quite make it. But Anders Gustafsson in control of that one. and the silver medalist behind Vancouver and last year at the World Championships, goes through as the Canadian did. Mustafa Mansour from Egypt, he looked a bit ill at ease at the start and doesn't really have the pedigree to compete at this level, but enjoying his moment in the Olympic Games and completing the second heat in the men's K1 1,000 metres. So Gustafsson was there, also going through Ben Fuyu of New Zealand, Ali Urenia of Belarus, Francisco Cubelo-Sanchez of Spain and Zhu Yubo of China.
That great technique and that real drive on the water, it made it look quite easy out there. I think the semi-finals that are going to come up a bit later on today are going to be the real test where we see the fighting really begin.
Confirmation of the five to go through there, the five guaranteed to go through. And Gustafsson and Ben Fuyu, Ali Urenia, Zhu Yubo and Francisco Cubelos. Madreza Telebian will have to wait to see if his time was quick enough, but I'm not sure it's going to be. Final heat in the men's K1 1,000 metres. Murray Stewart goes for Australia, the 26-year-old. Finished second in the World Cup event in Moscow last month. Max Hoff, though, I think is the man to beat. He will look to dominate as Vancouverden. And Gustafsson did in the previous two heats. Erik Veras Larsson, man of huge pedigree, 36 now. Gold in Athens. Rennie Poulsen outside him, 23-year-old competing in his second Olympic Games, took silver in Beijing in the K2 1000. Marek Krajcevic from Slovakia goes in lane 7. And outside him, Cyril Carré of France. A fireman from Auxerre.
Paddlers to the start line, please. Paddlers to the start line.
Very grateful to have good conditions
paddlers
here.
Forward to the start line, please. Paddlers
dry at the moment, just a little bit of breeze again. Fractionally behind and coming across from the right-hand side as well. Rennie Poulsen.
He's coming forward, lane 7, forward.
He's superstitious. He usually paddles with a toy on the front of the boat in international competitions, Poulsen, but I wonder if he's given it up for the Olympic Games. I suppose if you're superstitious, you'd continue.
Hold positions there, please. Ready.
It's perhaps fallen off.
Set. Stop. Lane five. You have a warning for start. Hold your positions there, please.
Veras Larsson has a warning for a false start. Set. Just sensors as he tries to push away early. And there they go.
Like a good start for Veras Larsson. Generally though, actually holds back in the races and comes through at the last minute, so I wouldn't be surprised if we see him a little bit down the field over the first half of the race.
Good pace early on set by Cyril Carré. Finished sixth in the K2 1,000 metres in Beijing. Krajcevic leading himself at the back at the moment. Going out quickest at the moment. Murray Stewart is there for Australia alongside Max Hoff. Max Hoff, a huge figure, 6'6", Troisdorf just outside Cologne, European champion the last 4 years, and he sets the pace now. I'm sure those times you've seen going through there are correct, because Murray Stewart is up there.
You see he's got a much quicker stroke rate than Max Hoff that's next to him, so it'll be interesting to see whether he brings that down and settles into a bit more of a rhythm. But Murray Stewart beat Ken Wallace to this Olympic place, where Ken actually got the bronze medal in the 1,000 metres in Beijing. Poulsen from Denmark is now up there leading, looking comfortable. He's got a short reach compared to some of the paddlers out on the water. Almost looks like he's got a broken bent arm. He doesn't quite get the same straight arm, which is where we would say the great technique is when you have a nice straight arm, but he doesn't seem to be struggling with it.
No, absolutely, very different to the others with that right arm, slightly crooked, and Poulsen takes them through though. Erik Vilas Larsen in fourth place. And again, these four, you'd expect the pedigree to come through, and these four are the star turns in this heat, the final heat in this men's K1 1,000 metres. And again, the noise starts to grow a little bit as they approach the stands. Coaches pedalling frantically alongside.
We'll expect to see Erik Vilas Larsen really pick it up over the last, once they come through past the halfway mark. We'll really soon see him creep back into this field. The four guys, tightest heat we've seen out here today.
At the moment it's Poulsen from Max Hoff, from Murray Stewart and Erik Vilas Larsen. Larsen looking to make that surge, doesn't need to at the moment. There's the five to go through. And a battle for fifth place between Cyril Carey down at the bottom of your screen and Mohamed Mrabet of Tunisia. Look at Vilas Larsen now making his move up alongside Max Hoff.
The rotation, the length of the stroke, the length of the stroke and the strength that he's putting in to try and get himself in that leading position. And Max Hoff is also challenging and coming back at Poulsen from Denmark.
Murray Stewart just fading a little bit, the Australian, as Mohamed Mrabet comes up on him, the Tunisian. We can't see Cyril Carey in this bottom lane in lane 8, but Poulsen, Erik Vilas Larsen, Max Hoff at the top of your picture, all looking comfortable. Mohamed Mrabet has past Murray Stewart, and we wonder where Cyril Carey is. He's not going to make it coming into our sights now, so it's going to be these five to go through, and Cyril Carey will hope for a quickest time. A more competitive race there in this final heat in the men's K1 1,000 metres, and Rennie Poulsen from Denmark pleased with his work.
Such a contrast in technique compared to the other paddlers out there. I think it goes against all the kind of traditions of what makes a good K1000 meter paddler, with the long strokes of straight arm and the great rotation. We see him there with a really short stroke, bent arm, and actually almost looking quite stiff in his body.
It seems to go against the natural dynamics of the event. You'd think reach as far as you can, take in as much water, but it works for him clearly. There's Poulsen. You can see his right arm is slightly more bent, closer, the paddle always closer to him.
That drive through the knees is really important too, and it's the connection from the feet that are on the footrest on the boat, and where they have the steering, the rudder, they have like a bar that they keep control of, and then it goes up through the body, through the core, and then through the arms. And it's getting that connection exactly at the right time when they put that driving stroke into the water to get the power.
No surprises yet with Poulsen going through here alongside Max Hoff and Erik Vilas Larsen. Mohamed Ali Mrabet doing well, finishing strongly. It's Cyril Carey who came through to take that fifth place. Murray Stewart it is who will have to rely on the fastest loser.